Hello everyone, welcome to the class with Sister Josephine. I am going to deal with class 9 and 10, English 2, Merchant of Venice. In the previous classes, we had seen Act 1, Scene 1, and today also we are going to see the continuation of it, and it is Part 3. Here we go with numbers from 120 to 190. Antonio, is that anything now? He's asking, is there anything of your concern now? He's asking to Bassanio. And Bassanio replies, Graciano speaks an indefinite deal of nothing more than any man in all Venice. He says that Graciano get involves in speaking too much idle talks and much more than any other man in Venice. He says that nobody in Venice speaks as much as Graciano speaks. That's what he says. He talks too much. His reasons are as two grains of wheat hid in two bushels of chaff. He says that his speech is like two grains of wheat that are hidden in the two bushels of worthless stuff. This means chaff means once the grains are cleansed, the outer layer of the skin part, what is useless, of course. So his words are like that. He says like two grains of wheat hidden in the two bushels of chaff. Worthless things. You shall seek all day ere you find them, and when you have them, they are not worth the search. Which means that you may spend the whole day searching for these two grains of wheat, and at the end you may find them. You may find these two grains of wheat in that chaff, but when you have that grains in your hand, they are worth for nothing after all this time spent in searching. That's what he means. To that, Antonio replies, well, tell me now, what lady is the same to whom you swore a secret pilgrimage that you today promised to tell me of? Now, Antonio is asking to Bassanio, okay, that's okay, well and good. Now, tell me, who is that lady to whom you promised to pay a visit secretly? And you also told me that you will speak about her today. Who is that? What is the matter? He is asking. And Bassanio replies, it's not unknown to you, Antonio, how much I have disabled my estate by something showing a more swelling pot than my faint means would grant continuance. Which means, he is telling to Antonio, you know, Antonio, how I have spent all my fortunes by having more wealthy way of life. I have disabled everything, so I have wasted everything by living a swelling pot, showing off more wealthy life than my moderate income would allow me to do. Than my faint means he has got very moderate income. That means he is getting very less income but living a very lavish, wealthy life, and he has spent everything. That's what he means here. Nor do I make moan to be abridged from such a noble rate. She means that now I do not complain that I can no longer live such a style as the nobles live. Sister, I am not complaining about that now. I can live as the rich and wealthy noble people can live. But my chief care is to come fairly off from the great debts wherein my time something too prodigal hath left me gauged. What he says by this means, now my main worry, my chief care means my main worry is that how to come out of these heavy debts very politely or very honorably. I want to get out of these debts. Debts means so much of money that he has taken from others. How to come out of these great debts and that I have collected on my head due to my prodigal hath left me gauged means prodigal means the person one who spends too lavishly and spends everything. So by my spending, too lavish spending, I have collected so much of debts, and I want that, I'm thinking now how to get rid of this great debts which I have spent in my lavish way of living, and that has bound and kept me in great debts now. That's what he's saying, left me gauged. Next now. To you, Antonio, I owe the most in money and in love. He is telling to Antonio that it is only to you, Antonio, I owe so much in what terms? In money and in love, both. And from your love, I have a warranty to unburden all my plots and purposes, how to get clear of all the debts I owe. That's what he is telling now. Your affection gives me enough strength. Your affection, I have warranty, means your affection, your love. No? Your affection, your love, your care gives me enough guarantee or enough strength to disclose to you all my plans and to pay off my debts. That's actually from you I get the warranty to do everything, and to you I want to disclose, I want to tell everything and get rid of all the debts that I have. Antonio replies, I pray you, good Bassanio, let me know it. So he's telling, okay, enough now, please tell me what you want, let me know it, what do you want? And if stand as you yourself still do, within the eye of honor, be assured, my purse, my person, my extremest means lie all unlocked to your vocations. He says that, tell me everything, Antonio. If your plan is perfectly honorable as you are, if your plan is perfectly as good as you are, you may be sure that my money, my body, all my incomes, all my resources, everything is available for your use. I will spend everything for you, but you should have a proper reason for that. That's what Antonio is meaning. Now Bassanio replies to that. In my school days, when I had lost one shaft, I showed his fellow of the self same flight, the self same way, with more advice to watch, to find the other fourth, and by adventuring both, I oft found both. Now, what does he says means? He tells, in my school days, means in my childhood days, in my school days, when I had lost one arrow, shaft means the arrow that they used for playing, when I had lost one arrow, I showed another one, watching carefully in the same direction to recover the first. Watching carefully, in order to get back the first one which was lost, he shoot another arrow in the same direction to get back the first one, but this time he was watching very carefully. Now, by risking the second arrow, I often got both. By doing so, what did he get? Because second time he had a watchful thought. So he followed the same direction and went in search of the second one by taking risk, adventuring both. Okay, he took risk and went in the same way to search, and to his luck, sometimes he got the first one also and he got the second also. So he found both. Next. I urge this childhood proof because what follows is pure innocence. He is telling here, I am citing this childhood example because out of my pure innocence or out of my harmless, I don't have any harm in my mind, or I don't have any malice thoughts in my mind. Just I am citing to tell you what I was doing in my childhood. That's what he's meaning. I owe you much, and like a willful youth, that which I owe is lost. Means he's telling that I owe you so much to you, only to Antonio, and like a self-willed young man, I have lost everything that I got from you. Honestly, you have given me so much, and I have also spent everything willfully, means so lavishly I have spent, like any other youth who roam around and do all types of things. I have spent everything. Everything I have lost. Now nothing I have. But if you please to shoot another arrow that self way which you did shoot the first, I do not doubt, as I will watch the aim, or to find both, or bring your latter hazard back again and thankfully rest debtor for the first. He means that, but if you give me another loan, he is asking now, another loan like the first loan, if you give me one more time money like the previous times that you have given me, I do not doubt, while I watch the aim so carefully. Now this time I will be very careful to watch the aim, for which purpose I am taking this money, that I shall repay you both. And after that, I will watch and do it carefully. And at the end, I will repay you back both the first loan, the previous loans, and this time what he is going to take. At the rate, I can pay back at least your second loan. If not the first one, if I'm unable to pay, at least the second loan now what you give me, at least I'm very sure I will be able to pay you back the second loan. And I will remain to you, grateful to you for all the help that you have given. And I will remain thankfully at your feet as a debtor for the first one. That's what he means. Okay. So, up to here we have seen today. Next. Now to that, Antonio replies, "You know me well and herein spend but time to wind about my love with circumstances." Antonio is saying, you know me very well, Bassanio, and here you are telling all these examples about the childhood and you are wasting my time and you are also testing my love. And out of doubt, you do me more wrong in making question of my uttermost than if you had made waste of all I have. Means that surely you are doing me wrong, okay, by doubting about the readiness to help. I am always ready to help, but you are doubting my readiness to help to you with a bigger amount of money. You think that I may not help you with a bigger amount of money because I have already given you so much of money than you would actually spend. I think you could actually, you are expecting from me and you are doubting my willingness to help you with a big amount of money. That's what he means. Then do but say to me what I should do, that in you knowledge may by me done, and I am pressed unto it, therefore speak. His link that holds, even if it means making me lose all my wealth, I am ready to do it for you. Even if I have to lose all my wealth, no problem, I am ready to do. You have only to tell me what you want. Just to tell me what you want. Exactly, that's what. If you know that I can do it, if you are sure that only I can do it for you, I am ready to do it for you. I will do it now. So, therefore, speak. Tell me what you want. That's what. So, that much is enough for today. In the next class, we shall see the continuation of the same topic and the question answers for this Act 1 and Scene 1. Stay healthy and learn easily. Thank you.